First thing I did was seal the jet up. It was leaking, had a few pinholes, mainly around the back of the jet, and there's a little bit there underneath the motor at the front. You should pay to do a leak down test before you start to do anything. Make sure she's all sealed. That's the glue they use on assembly in these is pretty poor. The hot gun glue that they use doesn't seem to hold down very good, so it pays to pull all those base plates out and then re-shoe glue them back in place. Now we're going to drill the hole in the diffuser and make sure you get this in the right spot. You got to cut that little plastic nipple on a bit of an angle before you insert it. Bit of epoxy around there. Shoe glue. Now we want to grease up the little brass, the drive shaft, brass bush at the end of the impeller. Put a little bit on there. We want to smear a bit up inside the hole here, where the shaft runs through. Just get your finger and smear a bit in there. Bit of marine grease. And we stick that prop shaft back into place and just relocate the rubber seal there. It tends to push out. Just poking back in. Now we're going to drill this out very, very carefully. If you get this wrong, you're going to have a big vibration in the motor. It's got to be dead square. Might pay to take that to a machinist and get them to drill it out to the motor shaft size. We're going to make a battery tray up out of some styrene sheet. Just heat it. I formed it up over this bit of alloy I had here. It's to fit the 2.2 batteries. As you can see there, I've got the 3S and the 2S. Alright, we cut them ends off. Cut a little notch out of the end there so the wires can run through carefully. Put a bit of foam around that to stop it slopping around. Now we'll just test fit that battery tray in there. It pays to not glue your battery tray in until the final setup, after you've got the motor installed and everything else. You got to float test it and get the balance right. You might have to shift the battery left or right to get it to sit level in the water. Now I sealed up the ESC here with shoe glue, waterproofed it fully. It's wrapped in shrink wrap, and I just plug the ends of it with shoe glue so no water can get in the ends there. Now stick some foam up in the nose of the hull so she stays afloat if it goes under or flips over. Now we got the motor installed. Now we're going to install the servo plate. We'll shoe glue that into place. Put plenty on it. You don't want it coming loose. As I said before, the factory glue doesn't hold it very good, so you don't want to rely on the factory glue, you want to re-glue it. Just checking that the rudder was working okay. Now that's installed, we've glued in the servo, a bit of shoe glue, just blobbed a bit on there and stuck it down. Leave that overnight. The next day we come back and we've got everything installed, plumbed up, battery tray in, float tested. If located the battery in the right spot so it's all balanced. Got all the water pipes nicely, neatly run through. It's picking the water up, running it straight into the motor, then out of the motor, into the ESC, then from the ESC out the back of the hull. I've got the wires nice and high there, so they're not going to be sitting in water if any does get in. The battery tray's all shoe glued in place there with a bit of Velcro around it, and she's all right to go. The female ends on the ESC. If you do buy that same ESC, you need to change the female ends over to 3.5mm. Don't attempt to cut the motor ones off, otherwise you'll run into problems there. That's it. Part 2's done, and we'll be in the water soon. Thanks for watching.